Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. Last time, we completed the Super Order and Cement for the Region contracts and the Lost Oil Tanker task. The next contract I'd like to complete is cargo from the ship. We left the White Western Star in Island Lake and will need it for this contract, as it requires us to pick up two oversized cargo containers from the abandoned ship, which is in a slightly tricky to reach section on the Drummond Island map. We left a fuel carrier here earlier, which we can fill up from. With the fuel topped up again, we can head into Island Lake. The next stop is the abandoned ship. Thank you. It's worth taking it easy through some of these narrow sections, as catching the rocks on the sides may damage the truck. If I remember correctly, in an earlier build it was necessary to manually load the cargo containers, but it seems we can only use auto-load now. It used to make turning around with the semi-trailer very difficult, and it still isn't exactly a simple process. Getting to the ship with an empty trailer is one thing, but with the cargo on board, the chances of tipping the trailer over increase dramatically, so getting back out is another matter. There is no clear path through the rocky section, but if you keep an eye on the rear of the trailer to make sure that it's tracking towards the correct side of the large rocks, it will hopefully stay upright. After topping up with fuel again, I'll offload the first cargo container onto the ramped flatbed. It may seem quicker and simpler to leave the container in the sideboard semi and use the ramp flatbed to pick up the second container, but the flatbed is far less stable due to the way it attaches, which makes getting back from the ship without tipping the cargo off significantly more challenging than with the semi. Again, check the tracking of the trailer and take it really easy. If the trailer does tip and the container falls out without tipping the truck over, the best way to recover in some cases is to move forward to a more open, flat section of ground where you can safely disconnect the trailer. Then use the crane as a makeshift winch to pull the container to the trailer before reloading it. Thank you. After topping up with fuel again, we can now head to the warehouse in Smithville Dam. As the Fleet Star is in Drummond Island, I'll use it to pick up the rammed flatbed with the other oversized cargo container. After topping up the Fleet Star, we can now run it to the Smithfield Dam warehouse to complete the contract. With that complete, we're getting very close to finishing up all the jobs for the Michigan region. The next task to complete a threatening accident, an unfortunate event, but I'll leave those for the next episode. Thanks for watching.